Now we are going to start with the unit that is the measurement. But before we when we start the, you know that when we buy something from the market or when you ask for something from a grocer, we need to take the thing in a given quantity. Suppose I need a 1 kg pulses, so I'll ask that I need a 1 kg pulses. So the grocer must have something to measure that the dal he's going to give me should be 1 kg. So that is what is a measurement. That means measurement is very, very important. We need to measure things. So first of all, we'll start with the basic concepts which we actually, physical quantities which we can actually measure. That is the first is the mass. What is mass? Mass is actually the amount of matter contained in the body. Suppose you have, like if I talk of this marker, so if I talk about the mass of this marker, that means the amount of matter contained in this marker. So mass refers to amount of matter which is there in the body. Mass is the amount of the matter that is contained in the body. And you know that suppose I take a mass of this marker on this planet, that is on Earth, and now I am going to if I want to measure its mass on any other planet, or if I measure its mass in Chandigarh and now I need to measure in Delhi, so every time its mass is going to be constant. So we can say that mass remains constant with which place mayever you take or which planet to which we take this marker, it is going to remain same. So it doesn't change with places. It doesn't change with places. Mass always remains same. And you know that it is not possible that you have a certain body and its mass is zero. No body is, no body has zero mass. So mass can never be zero, because if any body is made, obviously it is going to contain certain amount of matter. So it can never be zero. And if we talk about the units of mass, then the unit of mass, SI unit is kg, the bigger unit, and in CGS it is grams. And how we measure the mass? We measure it by a balance, that is the common balance which we use is a beam balance. Now we are going to study that what is beam balance, but before we start with it, I want that you should know that the bigger units also and how you are going to convert the units. So see, in 1 gram, how many kgs are there? It is 1 by 1000 kgs are there. Suppose you write like this, 1 by 1000, and you can actually write, you can actually convert this figure into this also, because these three zeros are in positive. So when you write in this way, you just put a minus sign, so it becomes minus 3 kgs. So 1 gram is equal to 10 raised to power minus 3 kgs. And if you talk about milligram, milligram is 10 raised to power minus 6 kgs. And we often use the term quintal also to measure things. 1 quintal means 100 kgs. 1 quintal means 100 kgs. And there's another unit, metric ton. 1 metric ton means 1000 kg. 1 metric ton means 1000 kg. And see, this is also a unit, that is the mu, atomic mass unit. This unit is actually used to measure the mass of the fundamental particles, very small size particles like electron, proton, neutrons. We measure its mass by atomic mass unit, and 1 mu is equal to 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 27 kg. So small, you can see that it is actually a very small part of the kg. So these are the units which we commonly use in order to measure the mass. Now the instrument that is used to measure the mass, we need to study that also. And that is something, a beam balance. That is a beam balance. You must have come across beam balance, like when you go to a grocer shop, when you go to a this thing, the vegetable grocer. They all measure thing by using this common balance, that is the beam balance. See, what does it actually consist of? It consists of a metal rod. This is a metal rod, two arms of equal length, two arms of equal length. And from the center, there is a pointer, right? And there is a hook by which you can actually hold it. And these are the metal rod, as I already told you. These are the pans. These are the pans, which are, and these pans are of equal mass and equal size and equal shape. Everything is same. They are exactly same, these, both the pans. And moreover, you know that they are actually suspended by the metal strings. You have seen that there are iron strings which are attached, to which the pan is being suspended by those iron strings. So they can be thread also, it can be iron chains, but commonly the iron chains are used because they can actually bear a weight. They can actually bear a certain mass. So that is why we use iron chains. So let's say this is a right pan, and this is, let's say this is a left pan. Right. So how do you use it? first thing. Suppose you need to measure a certain kind of pulses. If I ask, like if I go to a shop, I ask a grocer that I need a 1 kg pulse. So what he's going to do, he's going to select a given quantity and he's going to place it over the right pad. So keep in mind, the mass, the quantity whose mass is to be checked, you keep it on the right pad. And then on the left pan, what he does actually, he has a standard weights. We all know that we have standard weights. We have a this thing, standard weight of 5 kgs, 2 kgs, 1 kgs, 100 kgs, 50 kgs. We have those standard weights. So what we do, like when we keep it here, we keep the 1 kg, let's, because I needed the pulse 1 kg. So let's say that a grocer keeps a given quantity of dal on the right pan, and he puts a standard weight of 1 kg, let's say, on the another pan. So when he is holding it, it has to be noticed carefully that the pointer should be in middle. So what happened, when he starts now, he put the given quantity of dal this side and he put the standard weight of 1 kg this side, because I need a dal of 1 kg. So that is why he is putting 1 kg. If I ask for the thing which is 5 kg, so obviously he will put a weights which will, the sum total of which will is going to be equal to 5 kg. So now as I need 1 kg, so he has put the 1 kg stone standard weight on the this side. Now he is going to hold this like this. So a time will come when the he is going to adjust both the things, as he know that standard weight is obviously the correct one. So the thing which he can alter actually is the dal. Suppose if he just try to hold it like this, so the pointer should be in the vertical position, because when the pointer will be in vertical position, then only both the mass on both the side is going to be same. So what he does, suppose he put like this and there the mass of you can say dal is more and as compared to the 1 kg weight, then the pointer will bent like this. So what he'll do, he'll remove certain amount of dal from there. So the time he'll keep on removing till the pointer become vertical, and the time at which the pointer becomes vertical, it indicates that the both the things on the both the pans, they are just equal. So this is how you're going to use the beam balance. But you need to keep in mind, the rod should be like when you start, the pointer should be in middle, the rod should be of same length, and the pan should be suspended the distance of pan from the middle should be same, these pans should be same, and moreover the thing which you need to measure is kept on the right, and on the left side we use the standard weights. And if I put certain kind of thing here to be measured, so its mass is going to equal to the sum total of weights which is being put on the left pan, but the condition which is required that the pointer should be vertical, because when the pointer is going to be vertical, that only indicates that the pointer should be vertical and the rod should be horizontal. This indicates that both the things in both the pans are of same mass. So this is how we use a beam balance. So there are always, as we know that all the beam balances are not correct, or all the informations which are revealed by the beam balance is not always compulsory that they are going to be correct. So always there is a characteristic of the true beam balance, and that's there, that is, arms must be of equal length. As I already told you, the arms should be of equal length. Secondly, the pans must be of equal mass. It should not happen that it is of more mass or it is of less mass. They should be of equal mass. And third, the rod should be horizontal and the pointer should be vertical, because at that time only you are going to have the correct information. So this is what about the mass. Now we are going to start with the weight. I think you got it. So it's just the mass, and they keep the units. Remember the units also, because these are very important, because whenever you get a question or a numerical, you need to convert the units. And the SI unit, I think you remember that it is kg, and in CGS it is gram. So you need to remember that, right? So this is what about the mass.